the way in which Christianity connects to every part of life, because God doesn't create boxes, He creates a life. And it's all connected. And I think that's what we're saying here is you serve Him, He overwhelms you, and you serve Him because you love Him, and it impacts every area. This morning, walking my wife to school, we pray together as we walk. And I was praying for her, whatever the situation, whatever the meeting, whatever the class, whatever the interaction with somebody within the school, may they see in her the reflection of Jesus. And may she be somebody who brings glory and honor to God today, as she prayed for me. And so this workout, this conversation, what we're doing, the intent is to bring glory and honor to God. And whatever you guys do moving forward on this day, it's still the same thing. It's still the vision, it's the hope, it's what we do. At UPEJA, I don't care what faith background someone has, it doesn't matter to me. Some of the players I've enjoyed the most haven't been Christian. Muslim, Buddhist, Hindu, they become my sons. I love them. A few of them have called me a second father, means the world to me. Because we're just called to love the world. We're not called to judge the world. You're not the judge, you're not the judge, I'm not the judge. God will judge His own. But if we could just reach out, love young people. For me, that's the greatest thing of all. I don't hang out with old people too often. And so now for me, 40 and below are young people. Hey, you're young.
Young baby.
Compared to me, he is young. So. Yeah, anybody 15 years younger is a young person. Yeah. So for me, I just keep growing the population, which people I can call young people. Turning 57 this year, and I got a lot of young people. So what's crazy is when the athlete and their dad are both young people. Yeah, then that's crazy talk.
How you build the UPEJA team for the first one?
The very first thing. So I came here and everything that you saw today wasn't there. The only thing that was there was one building, and they hadn't moved into the second building. So there's only two buildings on the whole campus. And so when I came there, they had a club team. You remember the old system, Division II, Division I, Main Division, National Qualifying, Nationals, right? So they had never got out of Division II. So I showed up in 2004 at UPEJA, and a couple of players that I had coached at ASPAC were coming to UPEJA. So they were on the club team. So that's what I started with. But basically, pretty much the whole team quit. And we had to start over because they couldn't handle my practices. I had a tryout. My first tryout, 13 guys showed up. One quit halfway through the tryout. I had 12 players. That's it.
Because
it was too hard, for sure. Yeah. We win the Division II, we win the Division I, we win the national qualifying, and we go to nationals in our first year in 2006 and ended up in the Final Four. But no scholarships. We had just started the process. Yeah, it was a big transformation. Exciting for me, and some of those players on that team still some of my favorite guys in this country. But that's how it all kind of started. Was Pa James actually built the facility for us. I went to him, drew some pictures, told him what I wanted. So I got all the permissions, and then Pa James, he said, when do you want it? I said, I want it in July. He's like, that's only 1 month. So they worked on that facility night and day, 24 hours a day, to build that whole sports center with three basketball courts, 1 month.
1 month, you know.
1 month,
wow.
Yeah. So, you know, Pa James said, get it done. They got it done. It was amazing. And then we just, you know, we've been rolling since then. So scholarships and everything. But that's how it started.
When we are young, and when we were first starting doing it for basketball, when you first joined the ASPAC, you know, the reason why it was difficult is because at that time we did not have our current capacity. At that time here's the level of the problem. We might be above, but above maybe just above us a little bit. But today, if we have faced the same problem, we are solving at this level. This is not even a problem anymore. And so, my questions for you all is that 15 years, 20 years from now, if you get to be our age, will you be able to tell a story that we just told you? Because each one of us have a story. There is a power in that one story. For my story, it's called Pier Wonder Surga. For Steve's story, is that, you know, cement slab court building in 1 month, three basketball court. For Xaverius, he's talking about when I first started with all the pressure, I wanted to quit. But it is that one story that keeps you going. So you see, it's not about how many things I tried in life. It's not about whether I'm so passionate about it or not. It's a question of like, how do you stay on all the way until you actually finish a good race? And to finish that good race that's called life, you need stories. So now as you are young, listen to our stories, be inspired, now write your own story. When trouble comes, you need to realize, especially if you are believers like us, you need to know that there is a greater power at work here. There is the unseen hand of God. You know, so write that story. Keep on passing on. Keep on doing your best to think the way that you can do it. School, university life might not be the same way as for us, at least. And for you, obviously, in the last 1 year, it's changed a lot. Keep on pressing on. There is something to write about it. That story, my friends, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, you'll be sitting in this same spot, and you'll be telling the next generation, and you tell them, here's my story, where is your story? Start writing your own story.
I agree. And one of the things you mentioned about the keep pressing on, keep doing it. You know, David talked about accepting Christ at the age of 12. I was 8 years old when my heart was touched. At 17, I really got focused, started youth work at 17 and knew that that's what I wanted to do the rest of my life. So now I've been doing youth work for 40 years. I haven't stopped and I won't stop. Laura asked me the other day, why I just keep doing what I do? Why don't I aspire to do something more important? And it's because God called me into youth work. And I'm not going to stop. And I think if we can get young men especially, and girls, but young men, to find the way in which God's created them, the vision of which He's given them, and then do it. And do it for a lifetime. No matter what it is. Pursue Him and pursue what He's given you to do. And then we can make a difference. So this has been a great conversation. I appreciate you guys' time. So anything you want to say maybe to the kids or your group that might watch this?
You guys are young. Yes. Stay focused in the things that you know how to do. When you know to do something, right? Keep on contributing. Don't focus on like, do I get paid? Does somebody praise me? Those are all important. More important, contribute. If you fall, remember, babies fall before they can stand. Babies fall before they can actually
fall run. Forward.
You gotta keep on falling forward. That is why you're called young people. I feel I'm still young. Steve still is still young.
Still young.
We still want to do it, and we're not afraid of falling. We do this and we say that we'll learn from this mistake. Today we do this podcast. Tomorrow we know that, okay, what else can we do better? Keep on trying. Keep on going.
Jadi kalau kalian pingin jadi seorang pebasket, kalau if you wanna be a great person, ya do it kayak maksimum. Percaya sama diri kamu, jangan pernah ngebanding-bandingin kamu dengan orang lain, karena setiap orang itu punya keunikannya sendiri. Jadi lakuin apa yang terbaik dari diri kamu sendiri, dan itu namanya excellent. For me, just melangkah aja sih, itu aja, that's it.
Alright, so thank you again, Coffee with Coach. Max Coffee, we're still asking for this sponsorship. Be blessed, enjoy the life in which God's given you, and give Him some glory and praise today. All right, we'll see you next time.